beautiful city. We love Hong Kong as a city. We love to make it better. I think it's one of the, from an environment point of view, one of the best cities in the world, with our mountains, our seas, our very dense city, so we only use a little bit of the land for buildings, but most of our land is nature. I can walk out of this building and 10 minutes later I'm in pure nature. There's no city in the world, not New York, not London, not Amsterdam, where you can do that. Hong Kong has that. And it's a beautiful, powerful thing of our city. So I love to take care of it, and I hope you will also love to take care of it.
Learning, organizing, and then succeeding, success, and having some results. So I hope it will motivate you to do more projects yourself in the future. So I hope you really enjoyed it.
The most important thing get up when you begin. Baby golf, which we call something.
大人物去傾偈咯，可以從中可以知道佢哋做啲乜嘢，同我哋一個project咩關係咯。今日好開心可以同啲guest去傾咧，尤其是Natalie，因為我哋個組係做eco tourism，而Natalie佢嘅Vision都係負責去promote local local carbon嘅eco tourism，佢嘅分享都令我哋有好多得著，可以motivate我哋去將未來嘅eco tourism做得越嚟越好。
除咗Natalie之外咧，我仲有同Raymond去傾過啦，跟住我好開心，因為佢係搞呢個 pharmacy 嘅 K farm 啦，跟住我好開心可以以一個 social entrepreneur 嘅出發點去出發去睇點樣去可以做啲嘢去 impact 呢個社會，可能嚟 vertical farming 啊，咁樣喺學校跟住可以去 raise awareness， 以一個 business 嘅角度去出發。
係啊，同埋我覺得啱啱個 random 分組都幾有趣，因為我可以接觸到唔同組嘅一個組員啦，咁可以從中理解到原來佢哋做緊同一個目的，不過用一個唔同方法去做嘅一件事咯，我都可以互相學習一個好嘅機會。
咁我今日咧就係Natalie身上學到好多嘢啦，就例如我點樣可以 scale up 我哋嘅 project 啦，同埋可以點樣結合歷史啊，或者係。 點可以吸引更加多人去參加我哋嘅 Eco Tour
等等啦？我諗今次就我自己學咗好多嘢啦，即係睇到就係佢哋一啲 project idea 啦，同埋佢哋面對嘅。 難題咯，咁中間佢哋分享咗唔少都係，我諗係反映咗佢哋勇於踏出一步啦，即係做一啲以前冇乜做過嘅嘢，咁但係嗰個人手資源其實唔係話好多嘅，咁但係嗰個成績都係算係幾好咯。impressive 有一組就係講校內嗰個。 建築物嘅 efficiency 啦 ，building efficiency 啦，咁嗰度即係佢哋可以做到就係校內有啲關注嘅聲音啦。咁雖然最終嗰個 result 未必係佢之前 plan 過嘅，咁但係個過程我相信亦都係俾到個衝擊喺佢個無論 career path 啦，或者佢之後點樣選擇升學到可以幫到佢咯。
我見到新一代嘅年輕人好有活力同埋創意，可以為我哋嘅環境同埋氣候出多一分力，為呢一個項目嘅行業接棒。咁我想同年輕人講嘅就係繼續堅持 keep fighting。 因為呢一個氣候嘅路向係慢咗嘅，尤其是喺亞洲地區啦，可能我哋冇咁關注環境保育，但係其實我哋都有好多嘢可以做到，同埋香港有好珍貴嘅自然資源，我哋都應該去珍惜同埋好好利用。所以希望年輕人都唔好放棄啦，繼續推動即係打呢一場 uphill battle， 慢慢去感染身邊嘅人，令到佢哋都可以加入我哋嘅減碳同埋環保行列。